Good morning. Today we are basically try to cover the various grammar structure. Remember, the most basic form of grammar, that is regular grammar. We can call it by regular set also, by the set notation, regular grammar. And also, if we convert it, it is a grammar thing. And if we convert it to machine, that is finite state machine. And we all know the finite state machines, all non-deterministic finite state machine also can be converted to finite state machine. So this is the finite state machine understandable grammar. This is a grammar. You know that every grammar there is a four tuple. There must be start variable. We make it a start variable, and here 0 is the terminal, and s is the again variable. And whenever I told again and again, whenever a sentence comes, a sentence may belong to a language or not. If the sentence start from start variable with the legal productions, so then if and at the end there will be no variable, all with the terminals, then it can be shown, it can be decided by a finite state machine into accepted state. So that grammar is always a regular grammar. What are the rules of this grammar? The rules can only be the left hand side a single variable and right hand side a single terminal and a variable, or right hand side a number of terminals and a single variable, or only one terminal. This is the rule of a regular grammar. And again, if the variable comes at the end, we call it right linear grammar. Like this is here, it is also right linear grammar. And another here you say it is goes to epsilon, that is a variable. We will see it. We need to remove this kind of a grammar is got, but to drama to make it a very good language so that it can be understood. So we always try that no single variable can go to epsilon. So this is we can avoid it by make it only S can go to epsilon. So if a language consists in epsilon, that means nothing happens but it is accepted. Rather, in finite state machine, you say in the finite state machine this initial state is a finite state also, that means nothing happens, it is accepted, then we accept S to be epsilon. Instead of A, S is the start variable, and we know the what kind of grammar we get, what kind of sentences we get. We get 0 to the power m and 1 to the power n. In my earlier classes, I have told a to the power m, b to the power n, m and n no relation. Okay, so here there the alphabet is small a and b, and here the alphabet is 0 and 1. So this is a regular grammar, very useful. I have told you lots of cases that the regular grammar is enough. So now we will coming to the context free grammar. This is type 3 grammar. Now there is a context free grammar. What is the difference between context free and regular grammar? Context free means here left hand side can be only one variable. It may be start and it may be other variables also. By the way, I must say that a language consists of definitely a single variable, definitely a start variable and be more variable, and definitely one terminal it must be, otherwise or more than one terminals. Okay, and legal sentences can be there wherever we get a string of symbols. That symbols can be variable and the terminals, but at the end of the sentence there should be no variable, only the terminals and the variable to be replaced by this grammar. And this sometimes in books is called the phase structure grammar. So that you can from every rule you can get it. Again here you see start variable can go to epsilon. This is legal, but no other variable should go to epsilon. So here also in regular grammar, here I also shown that it should not be done. It should be S can go to epsilon. And what are the type of language? I have told you that it should be A to the power N, B to the power N, where A and B are the input alphabet. And here you see we'll get instead of A and B, instead of 0 and 1, 0 to the power n, 1 to the power n. So there is a relation. So it may be 0 to the power n, 1 to the power 2n. That is also a context-free grammar. We'll see, we can find a rule so that this thing can come, this kind of sentence can have. Then comes what is the context-sensitive grammar, and remember this context-free grammar can understand the balance parenthesis. You can call it sometimes called balance parenthesis grammar, A to the power n, B to the power n grammar. This is basically deterministic context-free grammar. Okay, but there's context-free grammar is another grammar is non-deterministic context-free grammar, and instead of our non-deterministic regular language, it is converted to same machine and regular language. But whenever we have a non-deterministic PDA, then the language becoming more powerful. What means by powerful? Powerful doesn't mean it is can solve the job faster, but it means it can understand more variety. Like I have told you, the palindrome language, like madam, I am Adam in Bengali, say Ramakanta Kamar, and there are lots of palindromes, funny palindromes are there in literature. But the palindrome detection by a hardware is pretty tough. You need a non-deterministic PDA. There are palindromes, can be again a two types, even palindromes. The number of terminals are 2n, and another is uneven palindrome. Both can be detected by a non-deterministic PDA, and we can non-deterministic context-free grammar. Our programming languages, we generally do not use this palindrome and all these things. It is very, very tough, at least our known pushdown, deterministic pushdown automata. So the context-free language has two distinct parts. One is deterministic context-free grammar, where the we can detect the that particular language by a pushdown automata, deterministic, and the language are balanced parentheses, 0 to the power n, 1 to the power n, a to the power n, b to the power n, a to the power n, b to the power 2n, all kinds of language, balanced parentheses, so that you can compare. But another powerful grammar is there, that is called non-deterministic context-free grammar, which is the best example is the palindrome. There also, if you scratch the rules will be this kind of thing. Left-hand side variable and right-hand side any downstream. But only one variable can go to epsilon, that is start variable. But regular grammar, we have a restriction that this variable should be at the end, right linear grammar, or at the beginning. But here you can have any number of variable at any places, any number of terminals in any places. So that is a context-free grammar. Okay. So then comes another language that yesterday I told, that is called, this is type 3 grammar. This is type 2 grammar. And this is type 1 grammar. This is also very powerful. And this kind of language is like I have told you, 0 to the power n, 1 to the power n, 2 to the power n, like a to the power n, b to the power n, c to the power n. It is not algebraic formula. It is not that. But it is here 0 to the power n means 0 comes n number of times, 1 comes n number of times. You can obviously say like 0 to the power n, and 1 to the power n, I can do it by deterministic pushdown automata. I wish another number of stack to count than 2. So I have a 2 pushdown automata can solve the problem. But unfortunately, it is not. Who will synchronize these two stack? So you will need a different machine, and then the machine is called the Turing machine. Turing machine, it is called linear bounded automata also. The Turing machine, you know, is the core heart of it is a finite state machine, but it can go right side or left side, one step, or head is read or right head. In the finite state machine, it's a tape, input is coming in boxes, and head can go only forward direction. At the end, it can say green flag accept and red flag not accept. Context-free also same, only the finite state machine attach a single stack so that it can count a to the power n and b to the power n or 0 to the power n, 1 to the power n. But again, the heart is a finite state machine and head is only reading head, and head can go from left to right only. But in context-sensitive grammar, this machine will not do. Then we need a machine, and the machine and the head is two head. Read head and write head together, like our old tape. We have two head, read head and write head. it goes through and it can read and it can alternate change the symbol with write, and the this read write head combination can go one step forward or one step backward, but it cannot be stationary. It might read or might not read, it might write or might not write. This is a single Turing machine, and the tape is considered as infinite. And if we call it as a both a some boundary of the tape, that's called linear bounded automata. Both is a Turing machine, and it is very, very powerful. It can solve all the problems as Alan Turing has discovered and designed in 1936-37. That is still the hour. All computers and all these things are basically a Turing machine. Okay. Thank you very much for listening. Have a great day.